the attorney?
They own?
Father, we thank you. We bless you. We glorify you. We know, Father, that all things work together for good to them that love you. And to those who are called according to your purpose, we honor you, Lord. We exalt you, Lord. Your name is above all names. Hallelujah. And it's in your name that we trust. Jesus, you are our shield and our butler. Glory to God. I don't see him on, brother. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Is the attorney? They are. Okay, that means I need to come back there one more time. Okay, Lord. Huh? Who?
Live on YouTube.
It is? Okay. Glory to God. Let's see. Is that true? Yeah, that's true. Now, let's praise God for faith coming alive. Amen. If you hold on for 1 second.
Yeah, but you didn't do the rest of it. When you do that over here, you gotta reset again. You know, see, you gotta reset the camera. So now I can't get to the camera.
Amen, amen, amen. Well, glory to God. I believe we're going to have a good night tonight. Glory to his name. Yes. Glory to his name. Hallelujah. We serve a good God. Our God is able to do exceedingly abundant above all that we ask or think according to the power that worketh in us. Hallelujah. Let's pray. Father, we come to you now in the gracious and mighty name of Jesus. God, we thank you that your word is alive. Your word is health and healing to all our flesh. There's nothing, Father, that will stop this mighty moving force that you're releasing in the earth. And Father, I thank you, Father, that it's time for revival. It is time for revival for our land. God, I'm asking you in the name of Jesus, let the revival fire begin now in the name of Jesus. Let the healing revival begin now in the name of Jesus, Lord God. I thank you. I praise you for it, Father. Now, Father, I ask you that you would move in a supernatural way all across the viewing audience. Father, that you would move over in Pakistan and Afghanistan and in Africa, Father, in the name of Jesus, like never before. And then, Father, let your glory be made known here in America, right here in California. Oh, God, let the power of revival, let the fire of revival begin to burn bright in the heart of your servants. And God, I thank you and I praise you for it in Jesus' name. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. Father, we thank you. We praise you. We glorify you. Now give your mama back the phone. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. We praise you. We glorify you. We thank you, Lord. God, you're so good. You're so good. You're so good. You're so wonderful. God, I bless you. I bless you, Father. I bless you, Father. I bless you, Father. God, your hand is upon us tonight to deliver us, to heal us, to make us free. God, we bless you. We glorify you. It's in you that we live and move and have our being. God, your word is life to us. Your word is life to us. We hold your word and esteem it highly because your word has the ability to deliver us and to set us free. So, Father, we thank you and we praise you and we glorify you for it, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, amen, amen, and amen. Well, welcome to New Life in Christ Jesus Church, where Jesus Christ is glorified. Amen. Go ahead, let's play this song. I want to sing you a song tonight. Amen. I want to sing you a song tonight. Glory to God. Turn the music down. Glory to God. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Praise you. Oh, we worship you. He could have walked away, oh, but the price he chose to pay. And as he looked ahead in time, why, friend, I'm sure you crossed his mind when he heard Pilate say, to the hill, take him away. There he paid sins all for cost. With his back to the cross. Now when tears fall like rain, and you lose more than you gain, and in your life there is no song, and it seems that all your friends are gone. But when it's all is said and done, friend, you've not lost. Oh no, but you won. So when your back is to the wall, remember his was to the cross. When your back is to the wall, remember his was to the cross. The grave lost his victory. And oh man, if where is your sting? When God gave his only son, your every battle then was won. For when your back is to the wall, remember his was to the cross. When David's only son, your every battle then was won. But when your back is to the wall, remember his was to the cross. When your back is to the wall. Amen.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. But Pastor Oka, come up here and exhort the people a little bit for me. Amen. Glory to God. There you go. God bless you.
Hallelujah. Good evening, everyone. Hallelujah. Glory, glory to your holy name, Lord. Praise his holy name. Well, we want to welcome those who is here, those who is watching this broadcast. Thank you for being with us this evening. Hallelujah. So we're going to be continually to pray for this upcoming traveling that Pastor Larry is planning to go forward with. Some of you remember that he planning to travel to South Africa in this coming September and Pakistan this coming November. So continue to pray for these trips, and if God put in your heart, sow the seed. Amen. Hallelujah. So God is good. He is faithful. He has opened the doors. He is continuing to lead him, direct him. And we know that God is faithful. And as he faithful to us, he is faithful to everyone. Amen. So we're going to believe that supernatural doors and opportunities will continue to open in your life. Amen. Some situations will turn around even in your families and your relationships. Amen. So because God is faithful. So also, I just want to remind you, those who may be local, to remind you that every Friday we do have a night of prayer. So we come together in unity. And I understand everybody was praying during the day, but it's something when we pray in unity, right? It's something that when we come together and we pray. So every Friday night we're here for prayer. We lift them before God. Every prayer, you know, when we receive the prayers, request, so we lift them to the Lord. And also we pray for all of our partners, all of our supporters, those who is the part of this ministry. We continue to pray for you and for the breakthroughs in your life. Amen. So, and if you're local in Sacramento area or surround the area, welcome to come on Friday night and be a part of the prayer night, prayer evening. So we usually start at 6:30. Amen. So that's kind of important, because it is when we pray in unity, there's a power in unity. We release the power of God and we pray in one accord. Amen. So the prayer is the very important part of life of every believer. So, and we understand as the lives is very, very busy. Different things come up during the week. But you know, we have to create that time set aside to be in the presence of the Lord, even in a personal prayer, and to pray and to not pray just a problem, because God knows what, you know, each of us going through, but to solutions. And this is why is the importance of the knowledge of the word. And God sometimes can give you the scripture of understanding of that circumstances or situation that you facing, and you apply the word of God on that situation and that circumstances, right? So because the scripture says that the sword of the spirit is the which is what? Word of God. So as we take that sword of the spirit and we speak to certain circumstances, certain mountains in our lives, and that should be removed. Amen. So that's the to learn how to pray the word. And when you study and spend time quality time with your Heavenly Father, He gave you understanding what word, what scripture to apply in your life concerning certain situations, right? Hallelujah. So that's very, very important. Also, to remind you, those who is the Spirit-filled believers, to pray continually in the Spirit. Amen? In the Spirit. So build yourself up with the heavenly language. Pray in the Spirit and pray with the understanding. And God gonna give you an understanding. Amen? Some of you driving, going to work, and don't waste your time to listen some music or whatever you was listening there, news. Continue to pray. People need the Lord. If we don't pray as a believers, as the people of God, who will? Well, we know that Jesus is the intercessor for all of us, but He also looking for the vessels of God in this earth who will continue to pray and stay in a gap for those who is in need. Amen. Hallelujah. So to say all of that, before Pastor Larry come, I'm going to be praying for you, for your families. Amen. Hallelujah. So Father, we thank you. We praise you. We glorify your name. We thank you, Father, for every person who is here, those who is here, and those who is watching this broadcast. We thank you, Father, in the name of Jesus, that you touch your people. We apply the blood of Jesus over your people. We apply the blood of Jesus over their families. We apply the blood of Jesus over their lives. Oh, Father, we thank you for the precious blood of the Lord Jesus Christ that been redeemed us, that been set us free from anything that is not of God. And so, Father, I lift unto you, Lord God, your people, and I thank you, Father, that the fresh fire, fresh anointing of the Holy Spirit move in their lives. Father, they be on fire for you. They will, Father, they are seeking you. They are seeking your kingdom. They are seeking your ways. And Father, that you will add it to them. And Father, we thank you for it. We lift unto you, Lord God, their families, their loved ones. We thank you, Father, in the name of Jesus, that we pray for their families and children and grandchildren and those who they pray continually on a daily basis. We lift them to you. And Father, we thank you, Lord God, that your kingdom come and your will be done in their lives. And Father, we thank you, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. And Father, we pray for those who need a healing in their bodies. Lord Jesus, we know that you are the healer. We know, Lord God, that you are the deliverer. We know, Lord God, that you're the one who set the captives free. And Father, we also, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, we are asking you, Lord God, for the work of the Holy Spirit. Let the conviction of the Holy Spirit move in the hearts of the people. And Father, show your people some areas in their lives that is not pleasing you. And Father, we thank you, Lord God, that your people, Father, that they will turn away from the ways that is not pleasing you, Lord. And they will turn the way, Father, that way you guide them, that you will direct them, Lord. And Father, we thank you for it in the name of Jesus. And so, Father, we ask you, Lord God, that you touch your people's body, especially those who are in need of healing. We pray, Father, for the healing power of the Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus, touch your people. We thank you for it in the name of Jesus. Your healing, Lord. Your deliverance, Father. Touch your people. And Father, we pray for those who need an inner healing, emotional healing, or Father, mental healing. We thank you, Father, in the name of Jesus. Touch your people, Father, in the name of Jesus. And Father, those who is the press of the devil, suppress, compress, depress. We take authority right now in the name of Jesus, and we bind every spirit, every depression, any anxiety, any demonic oppression and suppression that come against God's people. We bind, we loose it, we break it off right now in Jesus' name. And Father, we thank you, Lord God, there is the Spirit of the Lord is, there is the liberty. And Father, we thank you that your people walk in a liberty and a freedom for the Lord Jesus Christ. And we're giving you a praise. We're giving you a glory. We thank you, Lord. Lord Jesus, we thank you that you speak to each of us, Lord. We thank you, Father, that you are the Jehovah Shalom. Shalom. Peace. Peace. We break every spirit of confusion. We bind, we loose it, we break it right now in the name of Jesus. Peace. We thank you, Lord, for your peace. We thank you, Lord. Lord Jesus. Lord Jesus. We thank you, Lord. You are good God. You are faithful God. We're just giving you a praise. From the deep of your heart, just start thanking him. Just start thanking him for everything that he has done, continue to do in your life. Thank him for where he brought you from. Thank him where he leading you. Thank him. Lord, we thank you, Lord. We're giving you a praise, Lord. We're giving you a glory. You are mighty God. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We're giving you a praise, Lord. We're giving you a glory, Lord God. We thank you, Father, for the victories. For the victories that your people will not be defeated. They will not be defeated or defeated. But they will walk in the victory.
I need another song now.
None of your people, as they walk in obedience, they will not be deceived. They will not be defeated. We thank you for it. Thank you for it. Thank you for it. In Jesus' mighty name, hallelujah. Praise his holy name. Hallelujah. Praise his holy name. Praise his holy name. Hallelujah. Praise his holy name. Praise his holy name. Hallelujah. Praise his holy name. Lord Jesus. Lord Jesus, we thank you. We thank you, Lord, for your presence. We thank you, Lord. We're giving you a praise, Lord. We're giving you a praise, Lord. Hallelujah. Jesus, 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 touch your people, Lord. We thank you for it. And we're giving you a praise in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Well, continue to pray when you're at home, when you have a time alone with the Lord. Continue to pray.
Yes, Lord.
Continue to seek his face. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. Amen. Well, Pastor Larry is here. He's going to be ministering to us,
yes.
Right? And you're going to be ministering also with a song.
Yes, with a song.
Yeah. Amen. So, praise the Lord. So, get ready to receive in Jesus' name.
Amen, amen, amen. Amen. Glory, glory, glory. Amen, amen.
I need to be still and let God love me. I need to be still and let God love me. When this old world tried to push and shove me, I need to be still and let God love me. I need to relax and let God take over. I need to relax and let God take over. He'll take this load off of my shoulder. I need to relax and let God take over. When trouble's all around me, when my soul cries out for rest, when I feel that I'm failing, even though I've done my best, when decisions get so heavy, there's answers that I need. I know it's time to just be still and let God love me. I need to be still and let God love me. I need to be still and let God love me. When this old world tried to push and shove me, I need to be still and let God love me. I need to be still and let God love me. I need to be still and let God love me. When this old world tries to push and shove me, I need to be still and let God love me. Jesus, thank you, Father. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. We worship you. We worship you.
Amen, amen, amen. Glory, glory, glory. Glory to God. Amen. Well, let's get into the Word. The Word of God is ready to move right now on the behalf of any one of you that have faith to be healed. The Bible said, be it unto me according to your faith. No, that was Jesus said, be it unto you according to your faith. Amen. And so we're going to say, be it unto you according to your faith today. Amen. Because I believe that we serve a God and he's faithful and he wants to touch, he wants to minister, he wants to set the captives free. Amen. I like that because you see, the Bible says, and with great power, the apostle gave witness. With great power. That's in Acts chapter 4, verse 33. With great power, the apostle gave witness of the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great grace was upon them all. Great grace was upon them all. Oh, hallelujah. My brother and sister, I believe that God that we serve, he's full of grace. And his mercy endureth forever. Hallelujah. Amen. And then we see what it said by Stephen here. Amen. In Acts chapter 6, verse number 8. Amen. Glory to God. And Stephen, full of what? Full of the Holy Ghost, full of faith and power. He full of faith and power. And great wonders and signs among the people was wrought through his ministry. Why? Because he walked as a man of God. He believed the God that he served. Amen. Glory to his name. And I believe today that because I believe this is revival. I believe God about to release revival. The spirit of revival is about to hit America.
Hallelujah. I sense that so strongly in my spirit right now. Oh, hallelujah. I believe we're going to have visitation from angels. This year. I'm talking about this year. Before this year is out. I believe we're going to have visitation from angels. I believe revival is going to come through. It's going to begin to spring up in areas of America from the men of God and women of God that has a heart and are praying and seeking the face of God. Amen. You see, we have not because we ask not. Amen. So I believe that God is going to change some things. Amen. And I believe that there's going to be visitation. I believe we're going to see some things happening very, very soon in the spiritual realm so that we will know that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Amen. In Acts chapter 10, verse number 37, 38, I'm going to turn there and I'm going to read it. Amen. Acts 10, verse 37, 38. And we're going to go ahead on and the word I say, ye know, which was published throughout all Judea, and begun from Galilee after the baptism which John preached. And look at verse number 38. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. Oh, hallelujah. God was with him. Amen. See, and what we said about the apostles a while ago, look at Acts chapter, look, let's just turn over to the book of Acts. Since we're in that book of Acts, look at, turn over to chapter 4. Since we're already in the book of Acts, let's go back and see the account. What we just mentioned. Amen. So now, let's just start reading right here. Let's start reading verse number 29. Verse number 29. Amen. And now, Lord, behold, they're threatened. And grant unto thy servant with all boldness, they may speak thy word. See, we got to come forth with boldness, amen, to speak the word of God. Verse number 30 said, by stretching forth thine hand to heal, and that signs and wonders may be done by the name of thy holy child Jesus. Glory to God. And when they had prayed, the place was shaken where they were assembled together, and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost, and they spake the word of God with what? Boldness. With boldness. And multitude of them that believed were of one heart and of one soul. Neither said any of them that all things which he possessed were his own, but they had all things common. Verse number 33, and with great power gave the apostles witness of the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great grace was upon them all. Amen. They came together and they believed, they acted upon it, they prayed, and God began to move. God began to move. When did God move? When they was praying. When they were praying, God began to move. Amen. See, the reason why we don't see revival like people been saying we're going to be seeing, because the people are not praying. Amen. But if the people would start, like the Bible said in 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 14, he said, if my people, which are called by my name, will humble themselves and pray and seek my face, he said, then would I hear from heaven, and I'll forgive their sin, and I will heal the land. I will heal the land. God wants to do something right now in our land, but it's going to take us participating in prayer. Amen. Because prayer is what God is looking for. He's looking for his people to begin to talk to him. He's looking for his people to begin to call upon his name. Amen. And I believe we're about to see healings take place like we've never seen before. Glory to God. Glory to God. Now let's look at another scripture here. Let's look at another scripture here in Luke chapter 12. Luke chapter 12. Glory to God. In Luke chapter 12, I want to look here at verse number 17. And it reads, And he thought within himself, saying, what shall I do? Because I have no room. Because I have no room where to bestow my fruit or his goods. Amen. Verse number 18. And he said, this will I do. I will pull down the barn, my barn, and build a greater one. A greater. Am I reading the right place? Huh?
That was about the rich man.
No, I'm reading. Yeah. It's about the rich man. Amen.
He thought he had time.
Yeah, he thought he had a lot of time. Verse number 18 again. And he said, this will I do. I will pull down my barn and build a greater. Mm-hmm. And there will I bestow all my fruit and my goods. And I will say to my soul, soul, thou hast much goods laid up for thee. Thou hast much good laid up for many years, he said. Take thy ease, eat, drink, and be merry. Look at verse number 20. But God said unto him, See, when you think everything is going on and everything is just smooth sailing, that's when you find out you have a very rude awakening. Look what he said, verse number 20. But God said unto him, thou fool, this night thy soul shall be what? Required of thee. Then whose shall those things be which thou hast provided? You see, we have to understand we're here for a period of time, and when that time is up, we're going to be out of here, and no matter what you have here, you can't take it with you. That's why God wants us to walk in divine health so we can accomplish things for the kingdom and not stir up things for ourselves so that we can think that we have plenty of time when we put all this stuff in our storehouse, we build up these big bank accounts, then all of a sudden we're taken out. Somebody else is going to spend that money. Somebody else is going to eat your goods. When all the time you could have been using that money to reach the lost souls, to send the man of God and the missionaries to the field to minister as God desired. See, God want to raise up an army. God want to raise up an army. And glory to God, it take the anointing. Oh my God. Woo! It take the anointing to lift burdens and destroy yokes. You can't go out there with empty words and thinking that something is going to happen. You got to know that God, look, ain't that what we read about in Acts chapter 4, verse 33?
Yeah.
Amen. With great boldness they went forth, knowing that God was with them, and they spoke the word of God. God wants to bring revival, and that's going to come when people stop being selfish. People are so caught up in themselves, they're not seeing revival. Why? Because they're so caught up in themselves. They need to stop being selfish. They need to begin to cry out to God, and God is going to God, and you need to start releasing. You need to have an output as well as an input. You need to be willing to give as willing and also ready to receive. When you start to act in the order that God has said, you're going to not only see restoration come in your land, you're going to see restoration come in your relationship. You're going to see restoration coming in your home. You're going to see restoration coming in your children's life. You're going to see restoration coming in every area of your life, your business, and so forth and so on. God wants to do something in this land, and he wants to do it now. He wants to do it now. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Y'all understand what I'm saying? Because see, we're in a season right here where tonight we're gonna talk about healing. Why? Because that's what Jesus did. He preached and he teached and did miracles of healing among the people. Why? To demonstrate the kingdom of God. To demonstrate the kingdom of God. And so we're going to see the hand of God. Are y'all ready to see the hand of God? I believe for miracles right now. I'm believing for miracles right now. Amen. I am believing God for miracles of healing. Miracles to set the captives free. Glory to God. There we go. Now I'm ready. I want you to turn your Bible to the book of Matthew chapter 8, verse number 16. Matthew chapter 8, verse number 16. Let's look what Jesus did here. Now this was a prophetic word coming to pass from the book of Isaiah chapter 53. Now we see that prophetic word that Isaiah gave in 53 coming to pass right here in verse number 16 and 17. And it reads, Matthew 8, verse 16 and 17. When the evening was come, they brought unto him many that were possessed with devils, and he cast out the spirit with his words. With his word. And did what else now? And healed all that were sick. Verse number 17, that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by Isaiah the prophet, saying, himself took our infirmity and bare our sicknesses. Amen. And as we read that, we can back it up to verse number 2. We can see some things taking place right here that's gonna usher you right into the presence of God. Notice what it said, verse number 2. And behold, there come a leper and worship him, saying, Lord, if thou wilt, thou can make me clean. And Jesus put forth his hand and touched him, saying, I will, be thou clean. And immediately his leprosy was cleansed. Amen. Notice what it said now, verse number 4. And Jesus said unto him, see thou tell no man, but go thy way, show thyself to the priest, and offer the gift that Moses commanded for a testimony unto them. And when Jesus were entered into Capernaum, there came to him a centurion, beseeching him, and saying, verse 6, and saying, Lord, my servant lieth at home, sick of palsy, grievously tormented. And Jesus said, I will come and heal him. I like verse number 8. Jesus, the centurion answered and said, Lord, I'm not worthy that thou should come under my roof. When someone understands who you are as a man of God, and they are not moved by the circumstances and situations, they will look and they will declare, God, you don't have to come under my roof. I believe your word has the power within itself. I believe your word, when spoken by faith, will produce exactly what you say. So you don't have to come under my roof. Just speak the word only, and my servant shall be healed. Speak the word only, and my servant shall be healed. Amen. And I believe, folks, that we are coming into a time where you won't be able to go to a lot of places, because of restrictions. You won't be able to fly to different nations, to different countries, because of the restrictions they're going to put on the church. Because the world going, if you go as a church, if you go as a minister or whatever, you can't, you got to conceal it. Amen. Why? Because you tell them you're a minister, you want to go there, they're going to say, no, you can't do that. So you got to go as a what now? As a, you got to get yourself a visiting tourist visa. Amen. So God's going to give you, he's going to give you the wisdom. He's going to show you how to get into these places, because see, we got to be wise as serpents, harmless as doves. And then when you go saying, peace be unto you. And if the Son of Peace be upon that house, then let your peace rest upon that house and heal, that's what the Bible said, and heal all that are therein. That's what the Bible said. Amen. You got, see, you are the one God is sending. You are the one that has the anointing. You are the one that God is going to use to minister to the sick. Just like Jesus. God didn't come down and minister. Jesus walked around and ministered to the sick. But God was in him. But guess what? He's in you too. He's in you too. Amen. So God wants to heal. God wants to deliver. God wants to bring restoration to humanity. And I believe that as we stand and as we declare, I come to you in the name that is above every name. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. Shaka. See, I'm not coming in my own name. I'm not coming in my own strength. And I believe that as you hear the word of God tonight, that miracles is going to happen. People, you will be set free. The kingdom of God is going to manifest among you. Why? Because you have freely opened up your heart to receive. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I believe that we're going to see the hand of God. I believe we're going to see the hand of God. Hallelujah. Glory to his name. Glory to his name. Glory to his name. I believe this thing is God is going to show up and going to show out. Amen. Now let's look at something else here. Let's look at another scripture right here. Because I see, when the prophet Isaiah said it manifested in the book of Matthew. Amen. What do you mean? What manifest? Let's look at the book of Isaiah in chapter 53. Let's see what manifests in Matthew. What we just read in Matthew, we're going to see the prophecy coming forth in the book of Isaiah chapter 53. Amen. Let's look there real quick. We're going to glance at this. We're going to just read it. Then we're going to go on to something else. But notice what he said right in verse number 4. He said, surely he had borne our grief and carried our sorrows. Yet we did esteem him, stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. Here it is right here, verse number 5. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. And with his stripes, the Bible said that we are healed. We are healed. See, if God said you were healed, then why not open up your heart and receive your healing now? Amen. Because he's already spoken it. God is not going to take his word back. Amen. We see in the book of Matthew that everywhere that Jesus healed them all, and he cast out the devil with his words. Amen. What devil? The spirit of infirmity, the sickness and disease, and everything that was hindering them. He cast out with his words. Never lose sight of the thrill of serving God, because serving God is not some burden. My God, I'm excited when I get to serve God. I'm excited when I get to go minister to the people. I'm excited when people want to hear the word of God. Amen. What bothers me when they don't want to hear the word of God. That's what bothers me. Amen. But I believe we'll enter into a season of revival. The fire of God is about to begin to rest upon those that have a heart to serve God with and those that are just trusting God. They're going to see signs, wonders, and miracles. Amen. And I believe we're coming into that season that we're going to see more of it. More of it. Amen. More of it. Amen. Look at 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 24 says, He himself bore our sins in his own body on the cross. Some trying to say on the tree. So that we might die to sin. Amen. So that we might die to sin and live for righteousness, by whose stripes you have been healed. Amen. Now the King James Version said it a different way. Amen. Now I'm going to turn over there and read it from the King James. 1 Peter 2, 24. Amen. Now notice what it said from the King James standpoint. It said, who his own self bare our sins in his own body on the tree. There it is. That we being dead to sin should live unto righteousness, by whose stripes ye were healed. See, God said you already been healed. God said you already been healed. So when the enemy thought to try to take your healing away from you, now you have a legitimate complaint. Devil, you have no right to touch my body. I'm not operating in sin. I'm not living in sin. So what right do you have touching my body? Get your hand off me now in the name of Jesus. Amen. The Lord rebuke you. The Lord rebuke you. Amen. So now that we know what God said, I don't have to defend myself. Why? Because God has already defended me. I can stand on the promise, and I can see the hand of God moving as I stand on the promise. Why? Because God has already said it. His healing has already been manifested in the spirit. You just got to release your faith to receive yours. Amen. The Bible said, faith, Romans 10, 17, so then faith coming by what? Hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Amen. So if faith comes by hearing by the word of God, then I just know that in Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1 said, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, and everything is not seen. I may not see my healing right now. I might still feel the pain or something, whatever's going on in my body. Amen. But I know that faith is working, and I know that my healing is manifested. I don't have to worry about what I feel like. I just know what God's word says, and I believe, and I stand on what God has said. And I'm going to, and by faith, I receive my healing. You got to open up your heart. You got to be like a bulldog. You got to grab hold of this thing and not let go. No, not a bulldog, a snapping turtle. A snapping turtle here. You got to pry that mouth off if he grabs you. Glory to God. Amen. But glory to God. God wants you to be just like that snapping turtle. He wants you to take a hold of this word and not let go of it. That's why he tells us in the book of Proverbs chapter 4, verse number 20. He said, my son, attend to my words. Incline thy ear into my saying. Amen. Why? Because God wants you to understand what he said about you. Amen. Amen. It's a biblical, spiritual promise that God had made available to each and every one of us. My son, attend to my words. Incline thy ear into my saying. Let them not depart from thine eyes. Keep them in the midst of thine heart. For they are life to those that find them, and health to all their flesh. Amen. And then he said, guard your heart with all diligence, for out of it are what? The issues of life. The issues of life. So when we take the word of God to heart, and when we hold fast to what God has said, God will confirm the word with signs following. But you got to hold your ground. You cannot allow unbelief to have any place in your heart. The Bible tells us in the book of Mark, chapter 11, verse number 23. For verily I say unto you, that whosoever shall say to this mountain, be thou removed, be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, shall not doubt in his heart, but believe those things which he said shall come to pass. He shall have whatsoever he said. So if you believe in God for your health and your healing to come to pass, then you can't talk about how bad you feel. Because you're going to see that come to pass too. Whichever one you want to see come to pass, that's the one you have to start speaking. Amen. Your healing will manifest when you hold fast to the word of God and not let go of it. God wants to do something in your life. God wants to bring you to a place in him where you will experience his manifestation so powerful that sickness will be so scared and run out of you. Amen. They're gonna see the presence of God coming up on you. Then that sickness, it's gonna take off. You don't want to be. It can't stay there. Why? Because of God's presence. Because of the holy presence of God. The holy presence of God is gonna drive it right out of you. Amen. And that's why it's so important we stand on the word, because the word of God is full of life. Remember what he said in John chapter 1. In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God. Now get this part. And the word was God. Amen. So when you hold fast to the word, you hold it fast to God. And the word of God, it has the power of God. It has the nature of God. It has the anointing of God. It's all balled up in that word. And when you hold fast that word is going to produce the nature of God. It's going to produce the character of God. And it's going to produce the anointing of God. And you're going to find out there's no sickness in God. Amen. And you being his child, you walking up right before him, I want to tell you something. There's no sickness to be found in you. Glory to God. Jesus bore our sin in his own body on the cross. Amen. All genuine Christians believe that God delivered them from sickness and disease. Now, there's a whole lot of Christians that don't have no idea what happened on the cross. But there's a lot of us that do believe it. I'm one of them. Because I used to be sick. I used to walk around every day holding my... Oh, my God. I'm up preaching like this right here, holding my stomach. I was in so much pain. And one day I just got tired of it. But I couldn't do nothing about it. So I laid down on my bed and started crying like a baby. I balled up into a little knot and just started crying. And I said, God, I need help. Oh, God, I need help. I don't have no money. I don't have no insurance. God, I need help. Oh. Then all of a sudden God said, get up and read your Bible. And I jumped out of that bed and I ran to the door trying to figure out who was out there messing with me. But I tell you, folks, it was no one there. God was helping me to hear his voice. He was training me to hear his voice. Not only to hear his voice, but to do what? Obey. To obey his voice. Amen. To obey his voice. Because I was getting ready to go back to the bed. And as I was heading back to the bed, I remember what God said to me. Get up and read your Bible. I remember what I heard. And so I got my iron board. And I set it up and I put my Bibles across the iron board and I sat there and began to read the Bible. And then I made it to the book of Mark, then chapter 16 in the book of Mark, verse number 15. That's when the word started jumping off the page. It started jumping up. I mean, it started jumping at me. I started, whoo, what is this? But that word was jumping at me, man. It was jumping. He said, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. See, God commanded me to go. He commanded me to go to the world. Not just go to America. He commanded me to go to the world. He said, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. Amen. Verse number 16 said, he that believeth and is baptized shall be saved. And he that believeth not shall be damned. Verse number 17 said, and these signs shall follow them that believe in my name, he said. Shall they do what? Cast out devils. They shall speak with new tongues. And if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. Those words were jumping off the page at me, so powerful, so strong. It really caught my attention. I had to keep reading them over and over and over and over. Amen. Then all of a sudden, I received revelation knowledge of what God was saying to me. Revelation. Amen. This is not something that I learned by reading someone else's book. This is something I learned by reading the Holy Bible.
Amen.
Glory to God. I received this by reading the Holy Bible. And God healed my body that very same night. And I have been teaching this and preaching this ever since. Because this revelation God gave me. Now, I don't know what Kendall Hagin got. I don't know what Kendall Copeland got. I don't know what Jerry Savelle got. I don't know what none of these people got. I know what I got. Amen. They got what they got. I got what I got. And let me tell you something, folks. It works. It works. It works. Amen. Oh, believe me, it works. God wants to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think according to the power that worketh in us. We can do the works of Christ. Oh, hallelujah. We can do the works of Christ. Do y'all understand what I'm saying? God wants to heal you. God wants to deliver you. God wants to set you free right now. This is not something we need to wonder about. This is something that we can count on. Amen. We can count on God setting us free. Nobody said in Psalm 103. Let me just turn that real quick because I'm getting ready to close this thing. I'm going to release that anointing and I'm getting ready to close this thing. But I want you to see, because see, this is part of your benefits. This is part of your benefits. Amen. God has already gave it to you. It's already yours. You just got to be willing to release your faith to receive it. It's already yours.
Amen.
Psalm 103 verse 1 said, "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits." Well, one of the benefits that he had given us, he wants to bless his name over, is our healing, our deliverance. Amen. And look at verse number 3 said, "Who forgiveth all thine iniquity, who healeth all thy diseases." I like that, because he forgave me all my iniquities and he healed all my diseases. If he's already did it, then why do I need to walk around with it? Amen. You see, your healing has already been paid for, so why not receive it now? Why not receive it now? God can touch you no matter where you are hurting, no matter where the pain is in your body, no matter what caused the pain. You serve a God that is able to heal you and able to deliver you and able to set you free right now. All you got to do is believe. Remember what he said in Mark chapter 9, verse 23? "If thou canst believe, all things are possible to him that believe." And like I ask the people when I'm doing crusades, will you believe with me right now? Then I like to interpret it. And I say it again. Will you believe with me right now? The interpreter said it again. And all of a sudden, I said, in the name of Jesus, I release that anointing. And the power of God began to fall out there on them people. I mean, you can see the hands going up in the sky. And they start, You can hear it. You can see the hand of God touching and ministering to people. And I want you to know that God is the same right here in America that he is in Pakistan, that he is in Africa, that he is in Nigeria. Wherever, I'm telling you, we serve the same God. And he wants to touch each and every one of you. He wants to do it now. Father, in the name of Jesus, you say that thou canst believe. You said all things are possible to him that believe. Shalalabako. Father, you've already spoke the word. The promise has already been given. Now, Father, in the name of Jesus, we receive the manifestation of that promise now. I release that anointing. You said, freely as I receive it, freely give it. Father, I release that anointing right now upon everyone under the sound of my voice. And as they release their faith, Father, let your healing power rest upon them. Father, stretch forth thy hand now with miracles, signs, and wonders all across the viewing audience in the name of Jesus. And those that are here in the sanctuary, Father, I release that anointing now in Jesus' name. God, I thank you. I praise you for it. Now, Father, let the miracles take place right now. And then, Father, let revival start. Let revival fire begin now in Jesus' name. I thank you for it. I give you praise. I give you glory for it in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Father, I bless you. I bless you. I bless you, Father. I thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
I bless your name. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. You're so worthy. You're so worthy. Let your hand be extended now, Father, upon everyone that say within themselves, I believe. I believe. Therefore, I receive my healing. I receive my healing. Father, as they open up their mouth and believe, confess they believe, and confess that they receive, Father, let their hearts come in alignment with your word, and let your word come in alignment with your will, and let your anointing begin to lift that burden and destroy the yoke, and let that sickness flee from their bodies. Now in Jesus' name. God, I thank you for it. I thank you for it in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. Father, I thank you that it's done. 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 In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Lord Jesus. Praise you, Lord Jesus. Praise you, Lord Jesus. God, I give you glory. I give you glory. Amen. Amen. And amen. Well, glory to God. Hallelujah. Y'all get anything out of this tonight? I just pulled out my heart. I didn't really stick with no notes. I just stick with the word of God. Because it's the word of God that's going to set you free. Amen. It's the word of God that's going to set you free. Amen. Father, I just thank you. And I praise you. Right now, Father, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Shout out, Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Now, Father, as we go into the next phase of the service, I ask you, Father, that you would touch the heart of your people and have them to sow that significant seed. In the name of Jesus. No matter where they're listening, Father, right now, Father, I ask you to touch their hearts, that they will go to my website, LarryBergenMinistries.com, that they will plant their seed of faith in Jesus' name. And Father, as they plant their seed, then, Father, let them experience financial breakthrough. Financial breakthrough. Let their finances be healed in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Then, Father, let their eyes be open to the truth, because the truth is going to make them free. I give you praise for it in Jesus' name. Go ahead on and sow your seed now. Go to my website, LarryBergenMinistries.com. Amen. Plant your seed. Amen. Or you can just go to Cash App. Use your Cash App. Also, and you can just write my name there. You see my picture there with a military baseball cap on. Amen. Use that link to plant your seed there also. Amen. Or you can send it through the mail. You can send it through the mail. And that's P.O. Box. Make the check payable to Larry Bergen Ministries, or New Life in Christ Jesus. Amen. And that's P.O. Box 417913, Sacramento, California, 95841. We love you. We thank God for you. Sow that seed. Be blessed. And watch to see what God do for you even now. God bless you. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We know that all things work together for good. All things work together for good. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Praise you, Lord Jesus. Go ahead on to my website, LarryBergerMinistries.com, and plant that seed of faith. And I believe that you'll experience a financial breakthrough as well as God touching your body. Amen. Don't forget, we're getting ready to go to two nations this year. Before the end of this year, we're going to South Africa, and we're also going to Pakistan. Amen. And we believe in God for supernatural finances to come in to help us to get to these places. So every seed that you plant right now is going to be a part of that ministry. Going to the nations. Amen. We can use your help. Father, I just thank you right now for those that are sowing their seed and those that are releasing their faith, Father. I thank you, Father, that you're going to move even now, Father, upon their hearts, reminding them that they are not alone. That every situation, every circumstance that they encounter, Father, that you are with them to strengthen them and to bring them forth as though they be tried by fire, they shall come forth as pure gold. I bless your people now, Father, and I give you glory, honor, and praise in Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen. Well, glory to God. Amen. Now, if you're here tonight, you listen to me right now by the internet, you're viewing us by the internet or whatever. Amen. Watching by television. And you know right now that if you would die today, that you would not make it to heaven. I want to pray for you right now because God doesn't want you to perish and miss heaven. Amen. I want to pray for you because God died. He sent his son to die for you. And he's not willing that any should perish outside of the kingdom. Now, Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for every man and woman under the sound of my voice, whether they are open up their heart for the very first time to acknowledge you as Lord and Savior, or whether it's the fifth or tenth time that they are acknowledging you as Lord and Savior. Father, you're not concerned about how many times they've done it. You're only concerned about the condition of their heart as they come back to you, as they return to you. Father, you are married to the backslider, and so you've given him another chance. So I pray right now in Jesus' name for everyone under the sound of my voice that you may want to rededicate your life. Maybe you want to give your heart to the Lord for the first time. I want to pray for you right now. Say this prayer with me. Amen. Say, Lord Jesus, I repent of my sin. Forgive me, Lord. I've made many mistakes. And I'm sorry. Jesus, come into my heart. Create in me a right spirit. And renew me a clean heart. Jesus, I believe that you are the Son of God and that you died for my sin. Today, I confess my sin. And I believe that my sins are forgiven. Thank you, Father. I receive you now as my Lord and Savior. Amen. Your sins are forgiven, and he has come into your heart as Lord and Savior. Now, right now, if you just begin to just thank him for saving you, begin to acknowledge what he's done right now in you, I'm telling you, you will have a greater experience than ever before. Because the angels right now are celebrating your return to him. And for you that are coming for the first time, my God is really celebrating over you. Amen. That's how much he loves you. Father, I bless your people right now. And I thank you, Father, for the angels of heaven right now that are rejoicing over their repentance. And as they come and acknowledge God, God, you just meet them right where they are, Lord. And show them your love is from everlasting to everlasting because you are God. I bless your people now. And I thank you for what you're doing in their lives in Jesus' name. Amen, amen, amen. If you're here today, you've never been born again. You're here today and you know that you need a special prayer. I pray for you right now. Amen. If you need special prayer, I pray for you right now. Amen. Maybe you're here by the internet right now or television. I'm going to pray for you right now. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for those that are with us by the internet, by the television right now, Father. Father, I pray and I lift them up before you, Father. And I thank you, Lord God, that your hand rests upon them to deliver them, to set them free. I bless your people, Father. And Father, I give you all the glory and praise for what you're about to do in their life, what you're doing. Until we meet again on Tuesday night, be blessed, be saved, and know that God is with you. We love you. Until the next time, have a good day. Bye-bye.